thanks to the Air Service Command. The three commands are the backbone of an overseas air force. This is a global war. To understand the extent of our air operation, we must take a global point of view. You're looking at the world spread out from the North Pole. Today we have 15 air forces, all joined together by the network of the Air Transport Command. 110,000 miles of regularly scheduled routes, 4.5 times around the world. Over these routes, the ATC ferries planes from factory to front. It transports key personnel and delivers supplies at the rate of 10 million miles a month. It will take anywhere, anything that can possibly fit into a plane. Once it delivered to Alaska, a complete hospital in 36 hours. It flew a shipment of grenades from the United States to Guadalcanal in 4 days when our men needed them desperately. The little extra that can turn the tide of battle. This is the daily mission of the Air Transport Command. Our 15 air forces were formed at different times for varied purposes. The first four were the backbone of our development. The first and fourth defended our coasts. The second and third were training forces. 11 are in action overseas. 14 bombers were the nucleus of our first combat air force. They had escaped the Japanese drive on the Philippines. Out of bombs and ammunition, these battered early model fortresses headed for Australia, evading the swift Japanese expansion over the islands of the Pacific. This was the beginning of our 5th Air Force. The 5th is a self-made air force. At the start, it had to improvise with whatever facilities happened to be available in the area. Nevertheless, within 3 months, it had joined the Navy in the Battle of the Coral Sea. Helping to sink 19 enemy vessels. Some months later, a B-24 on reconnaissance located a column of Japanese warships moving through the Bismark Sea toward New Guinea. This was the 5th's big chance. Every available plane was sent into action. For 3 days, 162 American and Australian planes bombed and strafed the Jap fleet. Many of our flyers came in at mast high altitude to skip bomb the enemy. At a cost of only 6 of our planes, and 13 of our men, the convoy was smashed and an entire division of Jap troops wiped out. This marked the limit of Japanese expansion. The 5th proceeded to take the offensive against the enemy's formidable system of interlocking bases. Japanese pressure had been concentrated on Port Moresby. We countered swiftly. Our troop carrier command threw 15,000 men across the Owen Stanley Range in one air movement. Then kept them supplied with more than 2 million pounds of food and equipment a week.
guns were moved in, and the wounded evacuated on the return trips. Following the spearhead came the engineers. Sometimes they had equipment, sometimes they improvised. Whatever their tools, they built airstrips out of the jungle in record time. From these advance airstrips, the 5th was able to strike deeper into the Jap perimeter. The bomb. VWAC. We strafed enemy airfields and installations again and again. When the Japs tried to hide their planes in the jungle, fragmentation bombs suspended from parachutes blanketed the area. The 5th has destroyed over 1,500 enemy planes, 400 of them at VWAC alone. Our air superiority in the Southwest Pacific has been definitely established. To counter the Jap threat, we're building our own network of air bases on territory recaptured by our combined operations. In this task, the 5th has been reinforced by the 13th Air Force, which was organized a year after Pearl Harbor. Together, these two air forces are driving forward on one of the several roads to Tokyo. The 13th was activated with units from the 7th Air Force. Today on Hickam Field, the devastation of Pearl Harbor has been repaired, and a new and better Air Force is making history. Just a year after Pearl Harbor at midnight, the bombers of the 7th flew out of Hickam on the longest mass offensive flight ever made. With Midway as the only stopping point, they flew 5,000 miles to bomb Wake Island in a surprise attack. To the south, the 7th established its bases on the Ellice Islands. From here, it battered Jap defense installations on the Gilberts, paving the way for the successful assault of our amphibious forces. From advanced bases on the Gilberts, the 7th put into combat a new weapon. In addition to its deadly 50 caliber machine guns, this B-25G was equipped with a 75 millimeter cannon. Saturated by the firepower of the 7th,